Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at audio input and file recording. So the key to audio inputting on Pure Data or in Pure Data is the analog to digital converter. So this object will take audio from whatever audio devices are connected to your computer. It will take an argument about the number of inputs. I'm going to limit it to mono because I'm going to use my microphone as the audio input. So we can process that input in a fairly standard way with a volume control. Limit that to zero. And then connect that up. And that can go out to the output, the digital to analog converter. And so this will do the audio out. It may not be very audible to you because it's exactly my microphone input, but we'll visualize that so we can see it a little bit better. Move that across. We're going to use this object here, the VU meter object. I'm just going to reduce the size of my screen because there's a issue that when we put the VU meter in, when it's large, it can look odd. There we go. So back up. So this VU meter will show the level of the audio coming in. I need to use the envelope follower object, which will track the level of the audio coming in. And that level, when we connect it, is possibly going to be, as you can see, a little bit too loud. So we'll need to do a subtraction. Usually fine by about 90 is a fairly good value for doing that. Connect it up again. Come on, connect it up again. There we are. And so now as I'm talking, you can see that there's level. You might also notice that the level is reasonably low, down about negative 20 dB or so. So I'm going to insert in there a gain control for my input. On most mixing desks, it's not surprising to see a gain control. So this forms a pretty similar function. Just going to give it a zero base so I can turn it down as I need to. So now I've got this gain control in there. The gain is currently at zero. So if I start to increase the gain, now you can see that I'm getting a much hotter signal, which is probably better for the processes we want to undertake. So as well as bringing in the audio, it's useful to be able to process it in some way. So let's just look at some simple way in which we can audibly hear the processing of my audio. I'm going to do that by actually clipping the audio. Some default values for the clipping, going from negative 1 to 1. This shouldn't have too much effect initially. If we turn the volume up, we can hear that it's going, and you can see on my oscilloscope that as I talk, the audio comes in there as well. You can possibly hear it mixed in with my normal audio and a bit of phase differential there. So let's turn that down for a sec. I want to control this clipping amount. So I'm going to put a number box which will control the amount of clipping. I'm going to limit that between 0 and 1. We need to have a negative number here, so we can multiply that value by negative 1 to give us a similar offset on the lower part of the audio. So now if I turn that up, we can start to see that we've got some clipping. You can see it on the waveform here. There's some flat surfaces on the top as the vocal level reaches that clipped portion. So you can see that we can process the audio in this way just like any other signal that's coming in. We could instead, we could add filters or any other kind of processing that we like. Also in this, we're going to look at sending out this data to save it as an audio file. In PD, there is a object called WriteSF, which stands for Write Sound File. It will write out a WAV file for any audio data that's coming in. Because it's a mono signal, I'm going to specify one channel for our audio file. And then we connect the audio output to there, and that will write out any audio that's coming in our system to an audio file. Of course, we need to give our audio file a name, and so to do that, we need to pass some messages to the WriteSF object. If we use open, and we can specify a file name, I'm going to call the file mysound.wav, so that message can be passed to the WriteSF. In order to start recording, we use the message start, and in order to finish the audio recording, we use the message stop. So these messages are all here ready to go. So let's do a recording. I click open sound file, that starts, opens the file. Then when I start, now it's recording, and we can turn up the audio so we actually record something other than silence. And we get this sound, we can bring down the clipping so that it's much lower, and then bring it back up again, turn the volume down, get a nice fade out, and then click stop. So that's the audio file. Now let's see if I can see that in my system. That is here. So here is the audio file. Okay, let's open that up in Audacity. Okay, so there's the file in Audacity. Okay, and so there was our audio file played back in Audacity. So we've been seeing how we can get audio in, we can process it in some way, and we can write the result out to a WAV file for Prosperity. Give that all a go, and I will see you in the next video.